Hello, wherever you're watching me for this push tech, once again, continuing our satellite maneuvering journey. I want to see how I can attach 68.5 Intelsat 68.5E to this existing 36E setup. Now, this 36E on a single dish, this is where it's facing. It's facing down like this. Compare the two dishes. This one is facing up, this facing down. So normally, I told you that the higher the degree, the lower the elevation. This one has a higher degree than this 36 and this 68. This one a higher degree, a lower elevation. Compared to this one, a lower degree, a high elevation. But now what we want to do now, we want to move this one. Instead of using two dishes, I want to move what is here. I want to move it here. So the rule still remains. When you are attaching, it will not be the lower the degree, the lower the degree, the lower the elevation. And the higher the degree, the higher the elevation. So on a single dish, higher degree, lower elevation. But if you want to do it on a multiple setup, higher degree 68E, which is higher than this, will take its higher position. So it will now be higher than this 36E, which normally on a single dish is supposed to be lower. So this is the technique. So it's supposed to be this place like this, can see on a single dish setup like this. It moved to this side on a single dish setup. It moved to this side and went down. So it moved to this side and went down. But on a multiple dish setup, it will move to this side and go up. So just stay tuned. Let's do the calculation. We'll get back to you. Thank you. Okay, so we continue. Now we are attaching Intelsat 20 at 68.5E to Eutelsat 36E. We're using this frequency. There are a lot of frequencies. Go back to my past lecture where I insert, where I tracked 68 using this dish and see how I got it on a single dish. So what we're doing here now is we want to attach this to this. This one is already there, which is this. Whereas we're attaching it to this. So we're going to do the mathematical calculation to see the distance in inches, in inch, of these two satellites, 68.5E and 36E. Okay, we want to do some more mathematics here. Now, Intelsat 20 at 68.5E, we want to attach. Want to look at the distance between this and this. The distance is 32.5. Mathematically, it's 32, 68.5E less 36E gets 32.5E. My own calculation, if you divide this thing by 2, we get 16.25 inches. So the distance from our own rough calculation is going to be 16.25 inches apart. So you get your tape rule and measure 16.25 inches. Look at the way I did it. You can try it for other satellites. Want to combine two satellites, use the higher to less the lower, get the answer, divided by 2, you get the inches apart, 16.25 inches. So you can say 16 inches, 25, or roughly 17 inches, not really roughly, or 16, but you can just see within 16, 16.5 and 17 inches apart. So we're going to go to our dish. We're going to start tracking now. Stay tuned. Continue from our lectures. Attaching, we want to attach 68.5E to 36E setup. This DSTV is a pay TV. Some people have DSTV decoder at home, and they also have a free-to-air decoder. So this one is for free-to-air, while this one is for pay TV. So instead of getting another dish, we can attach this and get the frequency. So let's go. We're going to see the setup now. First of all, from our calculation we did, we said it's going to be some 16 to 17 inch apart. So 16 to 17 each, or 16 to 16.5 or 17 inch apart. And the inch apart is not starting from this place. Take note, it's starting from this LMB, because some of you use binding wire. So this, at this point, you tie your binding wire to the point where this one will end, stop. That is the 16 to 17 inch apart. So let me quickly do it now. Let me see, 16 to 17 inch apart. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so let's just fix it from here. For my measurement, from here to this place should be 17 inch apart. Remember, this scalar is not long enough for me to take it straight, so I have to attach another scalar to it to make it 17 inch apart. So let's quickly see the distance from here to here, and see the distance apart. So I think it's somewhere here, like this. Oh, it's coming here. Trying to guide the boats. So at the end of the day, we should have something like this. From this place to this place should be 16 to 17 inch apart. So let's quickly get our finder and confirm it. Confirm it. And see if our calculation is okay. Okay, so we are tracking with this frequency, 12.524 vertical 26655. That's what we are using to track. 12.524 vertical 26655 for the Intelsat 20 at 68.5E. So let's see. So see it here. So let's see our signal. Let's see our signal. So this is it. So we're going to get our tape. We're going to get our tape and measure it and be sure. This Redeem RTM. This Champions TV. This this Deliverance TV, and a whole lot of them like that. So that's how we got the signal. Which TV is this? So this is the, so you can see we've attached it. 36.
The one I'm working with.
And
the lion, the 68.
It's okay. So let's quickly get a tape roll and confirm the inch. Let's see that our rough calculation is okay. Okay, so remember we say we are looking at something like 16 to 17 inch apart. So we are starting from somewhere here. Somewhere here to somewhere at this place. To somewhere at this place here. So let's see. From this place to this place. See. Let's see what we got. We've got 16. 16. So the idea now is if you want to get your inch apart, I've got another rule. You use the higher one, less the lesser one, you get your answer, divided by 2, you get the inch apart. So I want you to go out there and practice it. We'll continue. Okay, so at the end of the day, this is 36E. And this is 68 feet. Look at the distance. Look at the distance from here. You can see the distance from here. Distance from this angle. Like this, the awful. This scalar to this end, joining another scalar to this end. The idea is because you can't get a scalar that has a full length of this, like this, to this place. So that's how we had to use combine it like this. So if you had there, the height is very high. So as long as you tighten this place properly, there's no how it will just be bouncing, but there's no how it will lose the signal. No matter the bouncing like this, it will still come back to the frequency, stable on the frequency. So that is this like this. So this is how you attach your 36E to your this is how you attach your 68E to your 36E. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to click the thanks button and support this work with anything. Thank you. Bye-bye.